Synonymous is the word. Synonymous. Synonymous is the word. When you got a man like Humphrey Day giving you instructions, he brings me up to date on every bum that's in this area like...
I beg your difference, Mr. TV announcer. I'm not a challenger. I am a champion. I've been a champion all my life. And I have you to know one thing. The things that I've seen of you lately have been extremely good. Someone has taken you under their arm and developed you. 6 or 8 months ago, I could have called you a paper champion. I could have called you a nobody. But you developed well. Your skills has gotten better. I'm older, I'm wiser, and I'm a better wrestler. And when I take the title from you, that's put yours truly back on the throne again. When I slap your face and abuse you, that forced you to do things that you didn't expect.
I love turning your light because you're a loud mouth. But you have a pocket full of money. And I want it. And I can assure you one thing. I'm going to put you down. I'm going to whoop the black off you. And I'm going to watch nappy-headed dog get beat by the TV champion. Dog, you a thief. But you got any money in your pocket, and I want it, I want it, I want it, and I'm guaranteed to take it. You're going to suffer, suffer, and suffer. Did you see how black and blue that egg-sucking dog was today? You see his head busted over his back, head all beat up, bruised up. Looked like he had been in a hatchet fight, and everybody had a hatchet but him. But I can assure you one thing, I know he's stupid. Very low. He's going to the bottom of the barrel. You know what they say about your kind and my kind? We can't stand one another because you're scared of me. And you better get out of here again because I'll hurt you for the rest of your life. We don't want no secret stuff. We don't want no secret stuff because we have a little necktie party for that egg-sucking dog. And I feel sorry for you for being such a big fool. No man alive possesses any more athletic skills than I. And why it is only a fool that looks upon the skills of a wise man and call it luck. I'm a very skillful man. I'm a very talented man. I'm a very well-conditioned athlete. And how can you call him an athlete? You call him a freak of nature. And a freak of nature, you do not stand a chance against Ernie Ladd. I'm known as the Einstein of the square circle, and there's no question about it. Madison Square Garden is my playground. Gonna get in the ring and dance all around you, all over you, up and down one side, you all the way down the other side, and then beat you right in the middle. I am the best wrestler in the world when it comes to big men. No question about it. You're running scared. I know you hate to be humiliated. You hate to be ashamed of yourself when you walk out of that ring in Madison Square Garden. And I plan to humiliate you in front of thousands of people in the garden and have it on cable TV, on national TV. I want everybody in the world to watch me beat you right in the middle. No question about it. I am the king of the square circle.
Now, he feels as though he could really hurt me if he could get a shot at the North American title and take my belt. You got a shot. The only shot you're going to get is right in your mouth. The big mouth. I've beat you on several occasions and I will beat you again. And if you stand in my face and call me a liar, slap your face real good in the general public. Going around telling people that you've never been beat before. I want you in the square circle worse than you want to get in the square circle. I will slap your face and whoop your belly real good for all my fans anytime, anywhere, big boy. Don't call me out because I am the true champion. I just get so sick down inside it make me want to throw up just thinking about how bad I would like to slap your face. I would slap your face in the presence of your parents, less known in the presence of all the fans, and pin you again, dummy.